This is Amie, Chapman, this is her 12th puppy, and this is Pilaf.
Welcome to Growing Up GuidePup. This week we took Pilaf on yet another outing. This time we tried outdoors, but she still had a little bit of sensitivity on this outing like she did last week. This week we decided to try taking Pilaf to downtown Palo Alto. There are still crowds of people here, but it's outside, no echo, and we were curious to see how she handled it versus last week at the mall. Now Pilaf kind of had a little bit of a meltdown in the mall where we weren't sure if it was the crowds of people or the noise that was bothering her, so we wanted to see what was going on with her this week. So being around lots of people didn't seem to bother her, but she was still walking fairly slowly. We decided to keep this outing nice and short so Pilaf didn't feel overwhelmed. All we did was take Pilaf on a walk up the main street in Palo Alto, University Avenue. On our walk, Pilaf got to encounter a few things that she's never seen before. Now, she is only 4 months old, so practically everything is new to her. University Avenue offers a lot of different types of distractions. While on our walk, we came across many people, families with strollers, and even a few dogs. We came across an area where there was not only a fountain, but some people playing some live music. And she actually stopped to check out the musician to try and figure out what that noise was coming from. Now, she wasn't overly excited, nor was she scared, so this is a pretty good reaction for her. Our next stop on our walk was the water fountain. Now this is a pretty big fountain, and the water runs straight down towards the sidewalk, so it can be a little intimidating. But once again, Pilaf wasn't frightened of it, nor was she overly excited by it. She actually stopped and took a look at it, and we walked around it a little bit just so she could get a good idea of what it was. She was walking rather slowly and a little bit behind me at times, and it's hard to tell if, one, she's tired, two, is she overwhelmed, or three, she's just really not into doing this whole working thing. So we've been talking with our leaders and trying to figure out what's going on with her and what we can do to excite her and make her a little bit more comfortable on these outings. So halfway through our outing, we decided to try taking off her head collar, because over the last couple weeks, she's had some reservations about me putting on her head collar and even walking with it. She doesn't seem to like it very much at times, but other times she's fine with it. So we're wondering if the combination of a new place and the head collar is starting to be a little overwhelming. So just out of curiosity, I wanted to see how she did without the head collar, so we removed it for the rest of the walk. Once we removed her head collar, she did have a little bit more pep in her step, and she seemed a little bit more comfortable. She was pulling also a little bit and a little off course, which the head collar really helps keep her in line and in the position I want her to be in without having to give her any harsh collar corrections. So this is something we're discussing with our leaders and also our community field representative to see how exactly they want us to handle this situation with Pilaf and her sensitivity to new places and her head collar. Now we're still keeping Pilaf's outings rather short, no longer than a half an hour, because she just can't handle it yet. We're also going to try limiting the use of her head collar. Anytime we take her to a new place, we're going to try her without it and see if that helps out with her sensitivity. And we're only going to use it on places where we know she's comfortable. Now we're still working really closely with our leaders and our community field representative on how best to handle her sensitivity issues. So keep watching and we'll keep you posted on how she's doing, and we'll see you next time on Growing Up GuidePup.